So let's take a look at another introductory model to kind of get us some familiarization with the way agent-based modeling works. So again, we're going to open NetLogo. We're going to go to the File menu. We're going to go to Models Library. And we're going to go to Social Science in this case. And under Social Science, you'll find Traffic Basic. And that's the model we're going to look at in this talk. So in Traffic Basic, the idea for this model, which actually was originally proposed by a school child, was to try and understand what causes traffic jams, right? And so if we hit the setup button, we can see the kind of the way the world is existing in this particular space. It's essentially, imagine a big loop with cars coming off from the left-hand side, driving along the world, going off the right-hand side, and then coming back on the left-hand side. So, you know, sometimes referred to as a Pac-Man world, where you enter, you go off the right, you come back on the left, or just a loop or a one-dimensional looped world, right? And in this particular case, you'll see a couple of things we haven't looked at before. We saw the monitors before when we were looking at some of the results in the fire model, but now you're also going to see a graph show up as well that's going to graph some data for us. In addition, you'll notice that there is one car that has been highlighted a little bit, and that's a built-in feature into NetLogo that allows you to illustrate one particular agent and what their actions are. So again, we hit setup already, so now we're going to let the model run. And, you know, originally the idea was to build a simple model of just traffic moving without any kind of hindrances or obstacles. But in this particular case, what you'll see is that the results were not as expected. So let's let it run and we'll see what happens. So as you can see, right, clearly, quickly, right off the bat, a traffic jam forms. And in fact, this traffic jam will persist throughout the course of the model unless and is robust to a wide variety of the parameter settings of the model. Not all of them. There are ways to set up the model such that the traffic jam doesn't form. For instance, you can really reduce the number of cars. But, you know, if I hit the model setup button a couple of times, you'll see that it keeps doing that, right? And by the way, you know, one of the nice things about modeling and simulation is that if we're curious about something like the statement I just made, for instance, that the number of cars dramatically influences the pattern of behavior, then we can, in fact, just stop the model, lower the number of cars, let the model run, and see that, in fact, in a world with a lot fewer cars, we get a free flow state, or a state in which the agents are moving at their maximum speed that they can. In fact, there's a speed limit in this model of 1, and they're basically moving right at it, right? But let's go back to the case where there is a traffic jam really quickly, right? So in this case, we set up the model, we let it run, right? And one of the things I want to point out is that if you were to describe this model from kind of a traditional statistics viewpoint, right? You might, for instance, characterize the minimum speed, the maximum speed, and maybe the mean speed. And a lot of times people have fallen in to characterizing using mean as a characteristic description of a system. But what I want to point out is that if you look at the model, there is no one, the mean speed would be right in the middle of this max and the min, right? It looks like it's around 0.227 in this particular case, right? But there's no car that is actually moving at that speed for any length of time. What happens is that cars go to almost zero, or go to zero speed when they hit the traffic jam, right? And then they accelerate almost linearly up in terms of their speed. And then they go back down to zero again. And so the amount of time that a car is actually at that mean speed is almost instantaneously zero, right? It's very close to being nothing, right? Which means that the mean speed of the cars is not a good characterization of the cars. And that's well illustrated by the red car, which happens to behave many in the same ways as the rest of them. So sometimes it's very important, especially when dealing with a dynamical system that an agent-based model produces, to look at the actual dynamics of the model and not just characterize overall averages and things along those lines. And one of the powers of agent-based modeling is because of the fact that we reify the entities within the model as agents, we can then quickly build visualizations of them that allow us to kind of understand and come to grips with those patterns of behavior.